This way.
Yeah.
Not much.
Ready?
Yeah.
I need another one here.
Okay. Have at it.
Okay, Bill. Where were you born in Kentucky?
Louisville.
Oh, Louisville.
Yeah.
So you ever get into horses? Or bourbon?
bourbon a little bit. Horses more.
I think that's your dad there with some of his daughters and probably one of his first vehicles.
That's at a cottage up in Michigan.
Uh-huh.
Where my family had the cottage.
So here's a shot of your mom and one of your sisters.
Yeah.
At Lake Michigan, right?
Yeah, these are old photos.
Yeah, that's the 1920s.
Yeah.
Is this on the farm in Kentucky, or?
They're my sisters. I had six sisters.
Yeah, six sisters. What did you think about being the only boy with all those women?
Yeah, I worried about it.
Heading west.
Yeah, that's when we drove from Cincinnati to San Francisco. Yeah, that's my mother and Jeanne, and I guess that's Kathy.
No, it's Susan.
Susan?
Yeah.
She's grown.
And that's your car. So you're headed west.
Yeah,
in fact, probably you're coming to school.
Yeah. That's the Packard car, which I wish I had now.
Now, Bill, what got you interested in photography? And how did you end up going to the California School of Fine Arts?
Yeah, that's a tough question. I joined the Navy and they put me in a photo unit.
Ah.
So that got me started at a career.
Oh, and so when you came to school, you used a GI Bill?
Yeah.
Ah.
So I had a head start.
And when you came to school, you must have, had you heard of Ansel Adams?
Yeah.
You had?
Everybody knew of him that was a photographer. He was well known. Well, he was a very affable fellow, talked a lot and about photography.
There's a picture of Ansel right there.
Yeah.
And Dorothea Lange. Looks like Dorothea Lange's in there.
Yeah, Dorothea. She was a sort of agent to get me headed. We would go visit Dorothea, a photographer friend of mine, one Harold Ziegart.
Right, Harold. Yeah, I was talking to Harold the other day.
You were?
Yeah, he said say hi to you.
Oh, well.
Yeah.
Good. That's Imogen Cunningham.
Yeah.
You know of her?
I actually hired Imogen Cunningham.
You hired her?
I hired her, yeah.
To do what?
To teach photography. I hired her and Lisette Modell.
At the art school?
Yeah. I'm still chairman of the department there.
You are?
I am, yeah. And when I was a young guy, I really liked Imogen Cunningham because she was quite a character.
Yeah.
Was she a character when you knew her?
To say the least.
You got any stories about Imogen?
I probably could dream some up, but I don't have any offhand.
Uh-huh. What about David Park? Did you remember David Park?
Figure
painter?
Yeah.
What did you think of him?
I liked him very much, and he got me to photograph his whole family. He had some daughters and a wife. Yeah, Edward Weston.
Yeah. Now, you apparently, since it has your autograph on there in 1948, you probably went down there two or three, four times to visit him.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
And we used to camp in his front yard with sleeping bags, and we'd spend the weekend at Point Lobos.
Oh, yeah.
And visit Edward.
Yeah. What about Minor White?
Well, he was a very important segment at the school. Was very influential on the students, too. And he was well-liked as a teacher.
Yeah.
That's Mark Rothko. He became famous as a painter.
For sure. He was there, so you hung out with Mark Rothko?
Didn't really hang out, but I knew him. I went to his classes. I thought he was an important fellow in the art world. I like that shot because it got some smoke that simulated one of his paintings.
Oh, right. It's sort of like that fuzzy space that he used in there.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, good, good.
Here's an interesting shot. It must be the Art Institute.
Oh, yeah, that's looks like Studio 13.
Florence.
That's Flo.
Yeah, Florence.
Yeah.
You know her.
Yeah, in fact, she's the world's most famous model at the school. Flo was a wonderful character.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A character, she was.
Wasn't she? Yeah. A lot of fun. What do you think of this shot? Apparently this is one of your most successful photographs here. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Well, there's not much to say, but to look at the photograph. And at one gallery, a guy ripped it off the wall and tore the print in half and threw it on the floor as a form of disrespect for the photograph.
And why do you think he was a little upset with that?
They taking away the stuff that liquefies my voice.
Oh yeah, yeah, I noticed that. Yeah. Well, your voice became a little bit more liquid there for a while.
Really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Here's another one.
That's the Third Avenue dump. We had a gardening business and we took our trimmings from gardening to this dump.
Mm-hmm.
And dumped them. And this was one of the scenes I shot on the way.
It's quite a nice photograph.
Yeah.
Yeah. They now have artists that get to go to the dump. And you have a residency and you work there for 3 or 4 months and you have access to all the garbage to make to make your art.
That's amazing.
I was here.
You were?
Yeah, how'd you get so close? How'd you talk yourself into standing next to JFK?
Well, I worked for UC at that time.
Ah.
As a photographer. So that was one entree.
Yeah, no, I was up at the top and I said, I'm going to go down and look at him when he leaves. I walked on down, he drove right by. Things politically have changed a lot.
I guess so.
Do you have any thoughts about politics of today?
I don't think so.
Don't think so, yeah. Did you like President Kennedy?
Yeah, very much.
Yeah, yeah. What do you consider yourself in your career to have been more interested in, film or photography?
Filmmaking.
Yeah?
Yeah. I went to the art school and I got acquainted with Sidney Peterson, who is a well-known filmmaker, and we became friends. And Peterson, he was sort of an inspiration for me. He taught at the art school, and I took his class, and it wound up that I was a friend of his in his career.
Didn't the two of you, start, was it Oracle Films?
Orbit Films.
Orbit Films.
Yeah. Yeah, with Peterson in Seattle.
Now I think of Helestes, my master, my dear one. And he went ashore from his traveling canoe, killer whale mask. And now my ancestors had for their chief, Helestes. No struggle for survival, no encroaching jungle. From the water, food. From the wood, a way of life. Gathering, saving, cooking, eating, sleeping. Old methods with new tools, old tools with new methods. This sliver of humanity has done well by the judgment of a whale.
Ago, the Cotton-Eagle Indians of British Columbia held their winter ceremonial in order to bring back the youth who was staying with the supernatural protector of their society. Lately, both the intention and performance of the winter ceremonial have been substantially altered, and their performance depends now on an individual and spontaneous will to recreate a very old, syncopated dance form.
Mr. Toby He's really quite famous in New York, you know. I understand he's what is known as a museum painter.
A pity. He's so Northwest.
Spaghetti.
Cobweb.
Does the hand just obey? You can be proud. Do you hear the buzzards that wait for your fall from the sun? You'll be loved when you're cold, artist. How is the going now? You want our soul, we have no soul, you'll make us a soul. But your shoes are covered with paint.
I think of cinemas, panoramic slights with multitudes bent toward some flashing scene, never disclosed, but hastened to again, foretold to other eyes on the same screen. And if they take your sleep away sometimes, they give it back again. Listen, the miles a hurdy-gurdy grinds, O arching strands of song. But now, draw in your head, alone and too tall here, your breath sealed by the ghosts I do not know. Draw in your head and sleep the long way home. O thou steeled cognizance, whose leap commits the agile precincts of the lark's return, within whose lariat sweep and cinctured sing in single chrysalis the many twain, descend and of the curve ship lend a myth to God.
And then another area that you worked in professionally, apparently you really got in pretty tight with Mr. Bechtel.
Steve Bechtel.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, they had jobs around the world, and I used to make it to those jobs as a photographer and photograph their action, their projects in the field.
I mean, that seems to be fairly interesting work. You got to go all over the world and travel, and you were pretty close, as I understand it, with Mr. Bechtel and Steve.
Fairly close, but I knew him better than he knew me.
And what interested you in doing, you know, ethnographic studies?
Dr. Barrett, yeah, he was the grandfather of ethnographic films. Do you know about Pomo Shaman? We filmed that in the roundhouse at Kashaya. Someone was with me sort of looking after that, and he made a circle in the dirt of the roundhouse that she was supposed to stay within that circle for the filming, which she did pretty well.
You have some more to say about that?
Only that she's dead. The film can't be repeated.
Matador,
Yacht Phoenix. This is WF-993. This is WF-9923.
It seems to us inconceivable that the United States would consider that the relief of civilians accidentally injured in a war was not in their best interest.
Wonderful people on the verge of extinction by the American military.
The ability of a people to smile and remain cheerful while locked in a war against the nation that holds the power to obliterate them all.
Make it or you blow it on your very first try.
You're fired, Adam. You're all washed up in this business.
You children off the streets. All deputies will maintain 24-hour surveillance until we track this thing down.
Bill, I tell you, it's been a tremendous joy to sit around here and talk to you and smoke a cigar and have a little drink of your liquid. Do you have any favorite moments, or you know, that you found to be some of your best filming when you were making those movies?
On American Indians.
From that experience of working with shamans and Native Americans, did you come away with any kind of a greater spiritual understanding of the earth or its people than you might have had as a young man in Kentucky?
Not really, because maybe I had that understanding before.
Freja.
Here. Oh, take the best part.
Oh, you got a little medicine.